What's going on, everyone? Welcome back to the channel. My name is Brooks. This is Anderson, where I focus on my C55 and MO55. Today, we're going to be working on adding the rear big brakes to the C55 used from an S55. You can find them on mini chassis. I'll link information below. I'm going to try to get the driver's side Recaro seat installed and then some other miscellaneous stuff, but big brakes and the Recaro seat for the driver's side are the big things. So get those going and see you guys over there. Got the new shift boot on, by the way. Looks a little bit different than those I saw it on IG. It had the little metal ring on it, but it was getting annoying. It was like clacking on this thing when I was driving. So I ended up just wrapping the boot inside of it and then securing it underneath. So now it's just nice leather boot. I will link where I got this as well below. This is only like 14 bucks. All right, just got over here, unloading all the supplies. Showed you guys these. You guys have seen them on IG when I first got them. And then there was a clip previously in another video, but these are the factory Brembo four piston rears. And these fit on the C55 with a couple changes. So first off, you can see I have these copper sleeves inside of here. I will link below the exact ones I used, the correct size. This is to adjust for the 10 millimeter bolts rather than 12. So those are secure in there, help with that. And then the only other thing you need to do is shave off a little piece of the hub on the backside to allow the calipers to clear perfectly. And then here are the upgraded rotors. And I'll tell you guys, I got a steal on these. These are Ray Bestos, like they're perform, I don't know, highest tier model, I guess, performance street, whatever. Interesting thing is these are made in Italy. So when I got them, I checked the other ones as well. I don't know where it is on here, but it says made in Italy on the side. So something I didn't know. You would assume possibly made in China, but they were not. These are originally like $120 per rotor, but I actually found these on Amazon for $30 a piece. So I don't even need front rotors. My front rotors are still good, but I ended up buying those as well because I found all of them for $30 a piece. So I got brand new brakes for basically 120 bucks. After tax and all that stuff. So worked out pretty well. Came up on that, would have originally been, I mean, you can pay an exorbitant amount of money for brakes for these cars if you wanted to. You can find cheap options, but this was super cheap, especially for like a pretty good model and good brand. I'm not a stickler about brake rotors. I usually run cheap rotors, to be honest, and they've always served me well. I mean, I do my research to make sure they're a high quality, you know, option, but I don't like spending a ton of money on rotors. You know, that's, I've been that way since I've had cars and they've always worked out well. The one thing I wish I could have found blanks. I didn't want drilled rotors and I don't really care for the drilled in the front either. I'd rather just have blanks. They last a little bit longer. They're a little bit stronger, but yeah, these will do. All right, got everything off, wheels off, looking at the brake hoses until this back one's actually cracking a little bit, so it's probably a good time for this anyways. These rotors are not old at all. These are Brembo rotors when FCP was still selling them. So these will be for sale along with these, probably like, I don't know, 150, 200 bucks for everything. It's got new pads, new rotors all around, no lip or anything. Yeah, just upgrading to the bigger size. Update for you guys. Just took the caliper off, took the line off. This is a 11 millimeter nut on the top to get the hard line off, and that will drop the soft line. The soft line is a 16 millimeter at the bottom, but yeah, like I said, you just have to undo that one and it'll drop down. I just left everything on the stock caliper. So these are in good shape. Like I said, I'm gonna clean these up and probably put them on eBay. So if you guys are interested, if you got a different C-Class, so these would be an upgrade for you. They work excellent. There's nothing wrong with them. This is, I mean, you could say it's kind of an aesthetic mod. I'm not much about the aesthetics, but it does help as well with heat dissipation, just because we're gonna have a bigger rotor and four pistons gonna give us better stopping power, even if it is in the rear. Kind of goes along the theme with the square setup, having the four pistons and square tire setup and everything else. Yeah, just figured it was a worthwhile upgrade, especially because I got everything for so cheap. So, like I said, if you're interested, I'll be putting that stuff on eBay. I'll probably put everything together, the calipers and the rotors, for, I don't know, 150, 200 bucks probably. So we'll see. But yeah, next step for these to fit, like I was saying, you have to grind down a little bit of the spindle and put the bore bushings inside of here. That's already done. And then I'll show you guys the spot that you have to grind these down. So right here, you can see they have these little like lips behind each one of these things. So on the bottom too, you just want to grind those down so they're flush with the rest of it. And that'll give clearance for the bigger caliper to fit on there. That's the only thing you got to do to get them to sit on there. And then the little bore center pieces too. Much better that looks. All right, so we finished this side. A couple things to talk about. Number one, we did have to grind down the brake dust shield. I ended up just cut it straight down. I'll show you on the other side in a second, but didn't want to waste time trying to make it perfect with the caliper. And then you just got to kind of massage out of the way. This part was hitting the rotor a little bit, so we just kind of hammered it out of the way after that. And the other thing, these stop deck lines were just like a tad bit short with these calipers. I mean, we could have got them in probably, but it would have been a little bit of tension when it's hanging all the way. So we just zip tied them basically to the brackets. So the hard line is zip tied to the bracket itself. So it's not gonna go anywhere, it's fine. I just didn't wanna try to wait and order longer lines or something like that. These are usable, so. Here's the other side. So that's what it looks like. Just cut the brake dust shield off and then just use a hammer and kind of work it around to bend it back a little bit so it's not in the way of the rotor. And yeah, so that's how the bracket is normally. But you saw the other side, what we ended up doing.
All right, so we got the stainless steel lines in the front as well. Everything is done on both sides in the back. I'm gonna show you guys. It's a little dark on this side. Man, it looks so much better. It looks proper for the car now. Matching all four. There's the other stainless line. And just in case, here's the part numbers. These are for the back. Now, you guys saw what I had to do because they were just a tad bit too short. So I would maybe call StopTech or whoever and find which lines are appropriate. Maybe you could get them like a half inch longer. That'd be good. These are for the front. So it's the same part number, but 001 is for the fronts and just 00 is for the rear. Yeah. Fronts worked fine. The rears, I had read that somebody said they were a tad bit short for the rear, but you know, the internet, don't know if it's true or not, but in this case turned out to be the case. So lesson learned, but we came up with a solution. Works just fine, not gonna go anywhere, so I'm happy with it. All right, so here they are the next day. Don't mind the crazy weather and leaves and dirt everywhere, but super happy with this mod. Turned out really solid. One of the most like rewarding mods for some reason. I just feel like this car deserved a better looking brake setup in the rear to match
Pretty nice setup in the front, so happy with it. Got four pistons all around now. Looks solid. Looks nice with the Motegi wheels showing through. So, all things said and done, super happy with this mod. Really, I don't know, shines out of all the things that I've done recently. I like this one. Things that you need, everything is listed below. We needed to cut the brake dust shield, needed to grind a little bit off of the spindle on the rear, just for the caliper to clear on the bolt holes. But besides that, relatively simple stuff, cutting, grinding, but nothing like crazy dramatic. And for the price that I got these parts for, super happy with it. One other thing I wanted to shout out to GarageMan01 on eBay. He is a seller that I got the parts from. He was totally happy to kind of give a discount on the price because he saw the YouTube channel and wanted to be a part of supporting the channel. So I really appreciate that. There's been more and more as this channel is kind of growing, people and companies that have been reaching out or I've connected with and want to be a part of it somehow. Want to see this build happen, want to see the channel grow. So I can't thank everyone enough and all of you guys for being the supporters and the subscribers of this channel. You guys know I started this channel just for fun. That's really what it's about to me. It's growing organically in its own direction. So I'm going to go with them. I'm just going to keep rolling, keep building, keep providing content for it. And, you know, sky's the limit. Putting that out there in the universe, let this channel become what it's supposed to become. Let this car and this build become what it's supposed to become. So anyways, I'm freezing cold out here sitting in the car. So hopefully you guys enjoyed. I'll see you guys on the next one. Got some big updates coming soon. And apologies, I know the MO55 content has been lacking. I'm trying to get on that. So stay tuned. I got something for you guys. Big things coming on the way. Thank you guys. Shout out to all the subscribers. Shout out to everyone on Instagram following along. Thank you guys. And I'll see you guys on the next one. Peace.